Is same-sex marriage a legal issue, a religious issue, or a civil rights issue? Proposition 8 passed on November 4th, 2008 with a majority of 52.24% and went into effect the next day. It officially added these 14 words to the California State Constitution. Only marriage between a man and a woman is valid or recognized in California. Proposition 8 elicited public outrage, civil unrest, and a short musical that became a YouTube sensation. Same-sex couples challenged the constitutionality of Prop 8, and their case, Perry v. Schwarzenegger, is currently in the California federal court. Interestingly, the two lawyers who opposed each other in the Bush v. Gore case in 2000, Theodore Olson and David Boies, are working together in this federal lawsuit, claiming that it violates the Equal Protection Clause.
Individuals brought the case. It's couples who are being denied their right to marry, and they brought the challenge to Prop 8. And it was rather controversial because they're bringing a federal challenge, and there was a lot of thought that the federal courts would be less hospitable than the state courts. And so some supporters of marriage equality didn't want this case to be brought at all. What makes the trial unusual is it appears that this is the first time, even though there's been a lot of litigation about the issue of marriage equality, this is the first time that a judge has required proof and evidence and witnesses.
Religious groups led the crusade to put Proposition 8 on the ballot. However, not all religions share the same point of view. We spoke with local leaders representing different faiths and opposing positions.
If a man who was created by God falls in love with another man who was created by God, who am I to judge that? And the same thing holds for women as well, obviously. You know, so I believe, you know, we're all created in the image of God, and we need to love that, and we need to respect that.
We hold to a position that same-sex marriage it is not something we can hop on board with. We're not in support of gay couples marrying and entering into that institution or that relationship of marriage. Marriage of two homosexuals isn't exactly something that God honors.
Because I think the Bible is not necessarily God's directive to us as to how it is we're supposed to behave and act in this world. It's that, but it's even more. I think it's a human reflection, human reflection of what people think God wants and expects of us. And I think what people thought God wanted back then is probably different with sort of modern sensibilities and understandings of what God wants and expects from us here and today.
The church actually believes they are, there's a couple terms for it, but basically they believe in a partnership, a Christian statehood.
If a gay couple were to come to me and said we love each other and we want to create a ceremony to sanctify the relationship that we have with each other, I would be honored to stand with them and do that.
Is same-sex marriage a civil rights issue? Coretta Scott King, widow of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., clearly thinks so. She has said, "I still hear people say that I should not be talking about the rights of lesbian and gay people, and I should stick to the issue of racial justice. But I hasten to remind them that Martin Luther King Jr. said, 'Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.' Gay and lesbian people have families, and their families should have legal protection, whether by marriage or civil union. A constitutional amendment banning same-sex marriages is a form of gay bashing, and it would do nothing at all to protect traditional marriages." In 1996, President Bill Clinton signed the Defense of Marriage Act. Under this law, the federal government is not required to offer any federal benefits of marriage to same-sex couples. Why is it so important that gays have the right to marry? For starters, there are a total of 1,138 benefits, rights, and protections provided to those with marital status in federal law. Without the legal right to marry, lesbian and gay couples are excluded from every single one. When Representative Seaborn Roddenberry of Georgia presented a U.S. constitutional amendment in 1911 which outlawed interracial marriage, his appeal to Congress was, "Intermarriage between whites and blacks is repulsive and averse to every sentiment of pure American spirit. It is abhorrent and repugnant. It is subversive to social peace. It is destructive of moral supremacy." These are many of the same words used by the opponents of same-sex marriage. Can a comparison be drawn between laws forbidding interracial marriage and Proposition 8?
So in biblical times, the idea is that homosexuality is a sin. It wasn't that long ago, you know, that it was a sin to have dark skin in this country. And, you know, all those people who were certain that there was something wrong with people who are of dark skin, with African Americans, they're wrong.
It's not an equal rights thing. It's a God says this thing.
The analogy is quite powerful in this way particularly. When the United States Supreme Court struck down the ban on interracial marriage in 1967, public opinion was overwhelmingly would have supported that ban. When the California Supreme Court in 1948 struck down the ban, I would say 80% of the electorate, if they were allowed to vote on an initiative, 80% would have said they wanted to overturn that decision. Now we look back on it with, I think, embarrassment that people would feel that way. And I have a feeling that that's what's going to happen on the issue of same-sex marriage as well, that in another decade, especially with the demographics being so clear that young people, even conservative young people, don't see why this is such a big issue, that they really see this about equality, that I think we're going to look back on this and wonder why has all this money been spent and all this teeth gnashing over really what's a relatively simple issue, which is to let people form a meaningful relationship with the person they love.
Is marriage, by definition, exclusively a union between a man and a woman? Or is marriage a basic human right? What will the verdict be of the current trial in California? We don't know, but we do know that in the 1987 case of Turner v. Safley, the U.S. Supreme Court found marriage to be a fundamental human right, which is protected by the Constitution. If marriage is a fundamental human right, yet the majority is allowed to vote to deny that right to any minority, could that be viewed as tyranny of the majority? That concern has been expressed for centuries in Plato's Republic, the Federalist Papers, and beyond. Speaking of fundamental rights, I asked Professor Levine if Prop 8 is the first constitutional amendment to restrict rights.
And it depends what you mean by a right. For example, a lot of people really like the idea that they can drink alcohol. And so we had an amendment, right, that of prohibition that prohibited the sale and use of alcohol. So I guess we've limited rights. It's relatively unheard of, and it probably is unheard of, to restrict civil rights. We've never had a constitutional amendment that contracted civil rights. They've always expanded and broadened the giving of civil rights.
Is same-sex marriage a legal issue, a religious issue, or a civil rights issue? It appears to be all three.